Assalamu alaikum, grade 2. This is Miss Angie, your English teacher. Alright, and I'm recording now this video to give you a summary about what we did in the first week of term 3. In term 3, we started with the new story, which is called Luke Goes to Bat. And we started the first day with the vocabulary. Number 1 was practice. Practice means to do something more than one to become better at it. Number 2, we did the word was harried, which means to hurry up or fast up, do something with speed. Number 3 was position, means in your proper location. And number 4 was extra. Extra means more or more than it is needed. Number 5 was cheered. Cheered means to cry out in happiness or encouragement, just like the picture. After that, it was roared. Roared means to give a loud and deep shout. And the next word was curb. Curb is the place where the street meets the edge of the sidewalk, just like this place where the sofa is located. And next it was final. Final means happening at the end of something. And this was the last word we had it in the vocabulary. And in the same period I answered with you page 2, which is the vocabulary of the vocabulary worksheet of the story. First, our team liked to practice every day. Number 2, I always want to get from the school to the field. It was harried. I always hurried to get from school to the field. Number 3, Mom dropped me off at the curb and I ran to the field. Number 4, our coach told me to get into my, and it was into my position. Number 5, many days we did what? Throwing and batting. It was many days we did cheered, throwed at batting. Number 6, our fans always, what when, sorry, number 5 was many days we did practice, throwing and batting. Number 6 was our fans always cheered when we ran into the field. Number 7, it was the extra player of the game would we win. Number 8, when I caught the ball and we won, all the fans roared. Alright, after that, my dears, in the next period, we started with reading the story itself. And in the first page in the worksheet, I did a summary for you. I put the story in a short way so you can get it so quick. Alright, we read the story about Luke, and after that, we answered the worksheet of the comprehension, which was page 7 and 8. Page 7, number 1 was the answer for it. He's just a squirt. One of the older boys said that. And the answer was B, to sound like real kids. Next one, he practiced his wing over and over. This is to show how hard he practiced. It was number H. And we answer page 9, which is the last page. What happens before Luke plays in the game? We said that he goes to a baseball game at Ebbets Field. Number 4, how does Luke probably feel when he strikes out in the game? He was happy. Number 5, what does Luke do after Frankie comes back? After Frankie comes back, I guess he hits a home run. And number 6, what happens before Grandma shows Luke the tickets? He said Luke tells Grandma that he had finally a chance to score. Yes, and this was the second period. The third period, my dears, was a grammar period, right? And we talked about antonyms. And we said antonyms is the word and the opposite of it, like clean, dirty. We have dry and wet. And we went through this PowerPoint presentation and we did like a small quick game. about the antonyms, and every one of you chose some antonyms. Here it is. Antonyms are words that mean the opposite of one another, like dirty and clean, happy and sad, and wet and dry. And after that we did the game, and we chose like up and down, mean and nice, large and small. You chose dirty and clean. After that, my dear, we answered 2 pages of the worksheets, which are pages number 3 and number 4. And by the way, I made this worksheet for you for 2 weeks, because as you know, the story, we will take it on 2 weeks. Alright, number 1 was Jill was sad. The opposite of sad is happy. 2, opposite of sunny is cloudy. Opposite of never, always never. Opposite of above was below. Opposite of wet was dry. Number 6, opposite of full, empty. 7, opposite of first, last. 8, opposite of early, late. And we did the next page, which was number 1, happy. 2, cloudy. 3, below. 4, never. 5, dry. Number 6 was empty. Number 7 was lost. And the last period, my dears, what was the writing sequence of events? And I shared with you this this PowerPoint presentation. And we said today we will write about sequence of events. I told you what is the meaning of sequence of events is to write a story in order from the beginning to last. And we said, think about it. How do you get dressed or ready to go to school? We said, first you woke up, I get dressed. What happened after that? I have breakfast, I brush my teeth. And I told you to share with me what is your routine about getting ready for bed. Number 1, getting ready for bed. You can have a bath. Number 2, brush your teeth. Number 3, wear your new pajamas and then go to sleep. And we did some exercises together regarding these pictures. And finally, we had the closure that good writer write a story in order. We call it sequence of events. And after that, my dears, we answered in the worksheet this page, which is page 5. This page, I told you we will write the sequence of how to get ready to go to school. Alright, we didn't do this topic, write a story about the hero. We did, just like the PowerPoint said, we did the sequence of how to get ready to go to school. Alright, and this was the end of week 1. Alright, my dears, now I will put for you some video that will help you during this week. First, let us hear the story itself. And after that, inshallah, I will let you hear what is the meaning of antonyms. Alright, let us start with the first video, which is Luke goes to bat. It's loading, my dear, and I will show it to you right
now. Luke Goes to Bat by Rachel Isadora. It was Brooklyn. It was summer. It was baseball. All day long, the kids on Bedford Avenue played stickball in the streets, except for Luke. When you're older, his big brother Nicky told him. He's just a squirt, one of the other kids said, laughing. So Luke watched the games from the curb, and then he'd practice. He threw a ball against the wall next to the deli. He practiced his swing over and over again. He ran as fast as he could up and down the block. He wanted to be ready when it was time.